Yay! Everything was on the table now. We'd made it. I told them that it was really cool that they both had sister before their name, and I can't remember their names. I politely declined their offer to an informative meeting, which I'm sure, to be honest, I would have loved. I asked them about their mission, and and how it was going, and I told them that I respected what they were doing in Selly Oak on a Tuesday night. Well, I got going, my dinner's on. Of course, said the brown-haired girl, thanks for talking to us. You're really lovely, said the blonde one. The brunette one agreed. They weren't just saying it, it's like they were sort of saying it as if to indicate that received loveliness from streetwalkers is pretty unusual. I was genuinely interested in what they had to say in Selly Oak on a Tuesday night. I guess they thought that was lovely. As I walked away, I found myself thinking about the blonde girl, trying to think myself inside her head. What did she look like? Do you scream into your bed sometimes, Mormon sister? Mormon sister, dear Mormon sister, you look as if you have a demon behind your eyes that cries sometimes. Is this how you console yours? For I cannot console mine. Our dreams are so different, and yet serve the same purpose. Respite from the absurdity of life. Mormon sister, dear Mormon sister, is this your truth, your magic? My truth is only that there is none. Do you find solace in your reasons, where I find solace in the lack of? Or Mormon sister, is it any